This video is presented by EA Game Changers, and a massive thanks to them for allowing me to take part in an Anthem Early Access Capture event. I appreciate it very, very much indeed. What is going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel, and I appreciate you being here. Today, I bring you some exclusive endgame Anthem gameplay with the Tyrant Mine Stronghold. Within this video, I am playing at a max level of 30 and rocking some amazing weapons, components, and just about everything else on my Interceptor. Also, at the end, being rewarded Masterwork gear. But before we get into the video, guys, I am giving away a full copy of Anthem to be in with a chance of winning it. Simply make sure you're subscribed to this channel, drop a like on this video, and leave a comment down below. More details within the video description. If you guys have already pre-ordered the game but would still like to show your support, you can by hitting that like button. If you are new around here and Anthem videos are what you want to see, be sure to subscribe. Okay, so at a recent London Anthem capture event, the last session we got to play was with top tier gear and took part in an endgame stronghold. Now, because I started late, I decided to opt into this thing solo, seeing what it was all about, and it wasn't until the very end a dev joined on me. So if you are wondering why this gameplay is like 35 minutes long, that is the reason. Shit's hard solo, people. And this was on that normal difficulty. So I was using the Interceptor Javelin. It's my go-to for sure. Love this thing. Set-wise, let's check out what I was rocking here. So let's start with the assault system I was using. I am using the epic variant of Spark Dash. Interceptor gathers strength, then charges target, damaging everything on path or a combo. Additional perks this has: combo plus 15% aura efficiency, plus 15% pickup radius, and plus 23% more shotgun ammo. Pretty damn cool, people. Strike system I am using is a Saladin's Respite, Masterwork variant, upgraded plasma star. Throwing star that melts through armor, hitting enemy weak points, instantly restores 5% shields. Additional perks: left bumper ability regens 20% faster, support ability regens 40% faster, sniper rifles gain 13% more ammo, and elemental attacks deal 40% more damage. Now that is crazy. Components I was using in slot 1: elusive talisman, Masterwork baby. Increase weapon damage by 25%, dashing 3 times refills the equipped weapon magazine. It states here also, support is plus 40% luck and plus 13% thruster life. Pretty cool. Component 2, assault system augment. Now this is an epic. Enhances the assault system to increase by 5% of base damage. It also offers plus 23% ultimate speed and a plus minus 4 shield refresh. Component 3, we have a rare, double-edged inscription. Increases all damage dealt by 35% of base and damage taken by minus 35%. Also offering supply plus 6% drop rate. Not bad. Component 4, we have another Masterwork, Talisman of Power. Increases strike system damage by 10%, and right bumper hit increases left bumper damage by 50% for 5 seconds. Wow. It also offers support plus 25% luck and plus 18% thruster life. I'll be flying all day with this setup, that is for sure. Component 5, we have Interceptor Combo Augment. Increases aural combo pulse frequency by 40% of base. It also offers ultimate plus 28% speed and shield plus minus 4% refresh. Component 6, Ultimate Inscription. An inscribed component that augments Javelin ultimate gear and increases damage by 5% of base damage. This also offers shield plus 80% refresh and combo plus 15% aura efficiency. Support system, I'm using a rare variant of target beacon. Locks onto target, reducing their resistance by minus 33%. If an enemy is defeated, effects jump to another. Additional perks, combo plus 15% aura efficiency and repair, plus 13% drop rate. So that is my setup right there, people. Weapons, I am using the Salvage Light Machine Gun, the epic variant. Additional benefits from this weapon: armor plus 25% max and weapon plus 10% mag size. LMG plus 23 ammo and critical plus 45 damage. Absolutely awesome. This is paired with the epic variant of the Vengeance Shotgun. Additional benefits: armor plus 26% max, plus 15% mag size, and plus 15% shotgun ammo, and critical hits do 15% more damage. So some beastly shit right here, that is for sure. So on a mission you may have seen before, if you haven't guys, you were in for a treat. The end boss of this stronghold, the Swarm Tyrant, is one big ass mofo, and it is quite a battle. But yeah, I will leave you to watch the gameplay, and at the end I will catch up with you to see the Masterwork rewards. So catch you then guys.
Thank you. bringing eggs to the relic.
The eggs were filled with acid. Could be using the relic to weaponize it.
Let's check the second relic. Put your theory to the test.
Reinforcements.
from below.
Of course it did.
Hate to say it, but that thing is probably what's producing the eggs. If we don't get rid of the source,
the scars will come back and keep making weapons. Bay, find me a way underground.
Already done. You know what they say? You've got to crack a few eggs to make an omelette.
I don't want that omelette. What is that?
Another relic. Careful, Freelancer. It's unstable.
I hate it when they do that.
What do we do now?
Gather the fragments and silence the relic.
Heads up, scars incoming.
How'd they get down here?
Bastards love to burrow.
Thank you.
almost done. Only a few fragments left.
notes everywhere.
Give it a minute, it should work itself out.
Should.
Energy readings are stabilizing. A bit slowly. Just stay in the center, any interference will cause the energy to spike again.
Thank you.
It's pretty dark in here.
Throw down a flare. It'll help.
You need freelancers of tools for everything. Back into the deep. To cut the link, right?
Highly.
Down it.
Next time, I expect big-ass bugs to be in the mission briefing.
You have to show up for that to help.
Even the way it dies is unnerving. One for each of the tyrant's legs.
No more scorpion talk, please.
So damn, people, although that looked epic, it was even better playing it. And as you can see, I got rewarded a new masterwork, the amphibious augment, power level 45, and this increases acid damage and oxygen capacity by 20% of base values, and acid resistance by 20%, additional perk, shield 3% refresh, and machine pistols plus 20% ammo. Not bad at all, people. I also got a full load of other loot too, but to be honest, nothing great there, or better than what I already had. I might bring you guys another video showcasing some of the best upgrades available and more that I saw, so stay tuned for that, guys. But on that note, we have come to the end of the video. If you guys enjoyed it, leaving a like really does help, as Anthem is a game I cannot wait for, that is for sure, and a game I will be covering on a daily basis, so make sure you subscribe if you never want to miss a video. But guys, thanks as always for stopping by. If you enjoyed the video, leaving a like really does help out. And hopefully, guys, I will see you on that next one.